So this is the abstraction layer seen by the application that is giving this illusion of a global virtual memory. This layer is the DSM software implementation layer that implements this global virtual memory abstraction. In particular, this DSM software layer, which exists on every one of these processors, knows at the point of access to a page by a processor who exactly to contact as the owner of the page to get the current copy of the page. For instance, let's say that there was a page fault on this processor 1 for a particular portion of the global address space. That portion of the global address space is currently not resident here in the physical memory of processor 1, so there's a page fault over here. And this is a cooperation, as I mentioned earlier, between the operating system and the DSM. So when the page fault happens, that page fault is going to be communicated by the operating system to the DSM software saying that here is a page fault, you handle it. What the DSM software is going to do is it knows the owner of the page. And so it's going to contact the owner of the page and ask the owner of the page to get the current copy of the page. So the current copy of the page resides over here. So the owner, either it itself has the current copy of the page or it knows which node currently has the current copy of the page. And so it's going to send the page over to the node that is requesting it. The current copy of the page is over here. It's going to come over to this guy. And recall what I said about ownership of the pages. The residency of this page doesn't necessarily mean that this is the owner of the page. The owner of this page could have been this node. So the DSM software would have contacted the owner, and the owner would have said, oh, you know what? That particular page, the current copy, is on this node. So the DSM software would go to this node and fetch this page and put it into this processor so that this processor is happy. So once the page has been brought in to the physical memory, then the DSM software contacts the virtual memory manager and says, I've completed now processing the page fault, brought the page that is missing, and put it into a particular location in the physical memory. Would you please update the page table for this guy so that he can resume execution? Well, then the VM manager gets into action and updates the page table for this thread to indicate that the faulting virtual page is now mapped to a physical page, and then the process or the thread can resume its execution. So this is the way coherence is going to be maintained by the DSM software, as a cooperation between DSM software and the VM manager, and the coherence maintenance is happening at the level of individual pages. And early examples of systems that built software DSM include Ivy from Yale, Clouds from Georgia Tech, Mirage from UPenn, and Munin from Rice. All of these are distributed shared memory systems, and they all used coherence maintenance at the granularity of an individual page, and they used a protocol which is often referred to as a single writer protocol. That is, I mentioned that there is a directory associated with the portion of the virtual memory space managed by each one of these nodes. And the directory has information as to who all are sharing a page at any point of time. Multiple readers can share a page at any point of time, but a single writer is only allowed to have the page at any point of time. So if there is a writer for a particular page, let's say that this page, which is now currently in the memory of two different processors, if this guy wants to write to this page, then he has to inform, through the DSM software abstraction, inform the owner for this page, let's say this guy is the owner for this page, that I want to write to this page. And at that point, the owner is going to invalidate all copies of that page that exists in the entire system so that this guy has exclusive access to that page so that they can make modifications to it. So this is what is called single writer, multiple reader protocol. Easy to implement. At the point of write to a page, what you do is you go through the DSM software, contact the owner, and the owner says, I know who all have copies of the page, I'll invalidate all of them. Once it is invalidated, all the copies, then the guy who wants to write to that page can go ahead and write to it because that'll be the only copy. Now, the problem with the single writer protocol is that there is potential for what is called fault sharing. We've talked about this already in the context of shared memory multiprocessors. Basically, the idea of fault sharing, or the concept of fault sharing, is that data appears to be shared even though programmatically they are not. Let's consider this page-based coherence maintenance. In the page-based coherence maintenance, the coherence maintenance that is done by the software, DSM software, is at the granularity of a single page. A page may be 4K bytes or 8K bytes, depending on the architecture we're talking about. And within a page, lots of different data structures can actually fit. So if the coherence maintenance is being done at the level of an individual page, then we are invalidating copies of the page in several nodes in order to allow one guy to make modifications to some portion of that page. And that can be very severe in a page-based system due to the coarse granularity of the coherence information. So for example, this one page may contain 10 different data structures, each of which is governed by a distinct lock so far as the application programmer is concerned. But even if I get a lock, which is for a particular data structure that happens to be in this page, and this guy has a lock for a different data structure, which is also on the same page, when I get the lock that is going to manipulate a particular data structure in this page, and if I want to make modifications for it, I'm going to go and invalidate all the other copies. When he wants to make a change, he's going to come and invalidate my copy of the page. So the page can be ping-ponging between multiple processors, even though they are modifying different portions of the same page, still the coherence granularity being a page will result in this page shuttling back and forth between these two guys, even though the application program is perfectly well behaved in terms of using locks to govern access to different data structures. Unfortunately, all of those data structures happen to fit within the same page, resulting in this fault sharing. So page level granularity and single writer, multiple reader protocol don't live happily together. They will lead to fault sharing, and they will lead to ping-ponging of pages due to the fault sharing among the threads of the application across the entire network.